Well, Jeff, how would you summarise the season so far for the Dundee Stars?
Well, it's obviously not turned out so far the way we would have hoped for when we were building the team in the summer. A lot of things haven't gone our way. And then there's other things that have factored in terms of the league has improved. Every team is, a good team this year, and any team can beat any team on any night. So it hasn't, always gone the way we wanted. There's been some, some highlights, but there's been a lot of lowlights, and hopefully the win the other night is a step in the right direction, and we can move forward and start putting some points on the board and get ourselves back into playoff contention.
Yeah, do you think the expectations from maybe fans and elsewhere in the league of the Dundee Stars this season maybe was just a bit too high, or do you think that maybe the pressure was a bit too much to handle at first?
I don't think the pressure was too much to handle. I think, certainly there were expectations, and I was afraid of that at the end of last season, that, finishing third and winning the Gardner, in our fourth year in the league, would put some added pressure on this year's team, and it did happen. And I think, we tried to from the beginning, really not talk about last year's team and really talk about this year's team. And, looking at the roster at the beginning of the summer, at the end of the summer, when we signed our last guy, I think a lot of teams or, a lot of coaches in the league would have said, I'll take that roster, into the season. And I think for whatever reason, you put in a lot of new guys in the room, and, it's not a magic formula. It's not a potion that you just, you throw some players on a roster and things happen. I think the fans last year got treated to a fantastic season. And I think there was that expectation that we would be challenging again, at the top of the league. But again, everyone's gone out and improved their squad, and they built on what they had last year. So a lot of teams return guys, and for whatever reason, it hasn't worked out our way. But again, the season's, there's still a lot of games left in the season, and a few injuries on a few teams, turn things around. And again, it's all about confidence. I think, you get a team like Edinburgh, they had 5 wins in a row, and all of a sudden they're sitting in 6. So I mean, you can't go into every game thinking that you're out of it, because if you do, then you'll never get yourself out of it. And I think it's been difficult, and a lot of guys in the room, I'll give them credit. I think, a lot of teams and a lot of guys and characters would have folded by now, I think. But, the heart and determination we showed on Sunday against Hull, and kind of just fought through it, and, got the 2 points, and hopefully that's the turning point for our season.
Yeah, a turning point for the season. You have made a few new signings recently. How do you think they fit into the roster and at the club?
Well, obviously it was a big blow losing, two, I would say, key guys to the team. Whatever reasons, will stay between us and the player. We've brought in Sean Ringrose, quality player, quite young, ambitious. He's settled in right away. He's a smart and calm player out there. And again, he's a guy that's finding his feet in pro hockey, and so far I like what I see. And he's a guy that is easy to work with, and what you get from him every night. And the other guy is Timo, and obviously Timo, he's played in the top leagues in Finland, and he's played in France in the top league. He's got a touch around the net. But unfortunately, he hasn't played for, since last year. So it's going to take him some time to kind of get back to match fitness. But, in the last 3 games, he's showed flash that he could be a very good player in this league. Again, we're still a little bit short bodies with the injury to Blight. But if he comes back, we're hopeful that he'll be back soon. And we'll see our roster take shape, with the new guys. And I think, you know, in terms of the guys' unity, I think it's definitely there. I think, you know, we've had, you know, a lot of bad luck during the season, and I think the guys have fought through it. And again, once we settle the roster here, you know, we move forward, and wherever we end up at the end of the year, all I ask for is that we go down fighting and continue on to work hard every game.
Well, last weekend saw an overtime win to Hull. How much of a lift did that give to the club and to the guys in the dressing room?
Certainly, I think, you know, we had a little time away from the rink after last Sunday's away loss to Edinburgh. You know, we kind of just got together as a team and just forgot about hockey for a couple of days and just kind of made a rule that we wouldn't talk about hockey for the entire night. And you know, it seemed to work. I think guys came back refreshed and into practice, you know, last week, and smiles on their face. And, you know, and then certainly winning against Hull on Sundays, you know, was a step in the right direction. And, you know, it was a sense of relief, but it also was, you know, kind of proved to ourselves that we can beat teams in this league, and that, you know, on any night, if we put in a solid graph, then, you know, the results will start to go our way.
And this weekend, a doubleheader against Brayhead. They've had a phenomenal start to the season. How do you try and pick up some results out of that, Jeff?
Well, I mean, you have to work hard. I think they're, you know, they're a clinical team. They've got a lot of different facets to their game. They're getting really good goaltending. They're well coached. You know, systematically, there's not many better out there. You know. But sometimes if you work hard, working hard sometimes beats skill, and that's what we're going to have to do. We're going to have to put our work boots on for the next two games and, you know, play really disciplined and throw up tons of pucks in the net and you know, let the results be what they are. But, you know, again, as long as we're working hard and you know, leaving it all on the ice, I think that's all, you know, our fan base and all I can ask of our guys.
That's great. Thanks.
No problem.